Descriptive validity refers to the researcher's successful capture and representation of the facts on the ground. Has the researcher been complete and honest in the representation of what he observed? Would any other observer present in the scene have described the same interactions, the same statements, in effect, the same facts? Is there other evidence to back up the researcher's description? All other categories of validity depend on descriptive validity, and consequently, robust data collection and data gathering is the foundation, the essential, necessary condition, the first step and basic criterion for all qualitative research. It's impossible to overstate this. The need for detailed, accurate description, as it also creates additional legitimacy for conversational interviewing rather than survey research or prescriptive face-to-face interviews. Failures to achieve descriptive validity are frequently the result of both insufficient data gathering and insufficient reporting of what was observed, regardless of whether the researcher is conducting interviews or doing participant observation fieldwork. Failures to achieve descriptive validity do not, however, necessarily come about through active dishonesty or when researchers may make mistakes or misremember events. More often, descriptive validity is compromised by the insufficiency of the reported data. Descriptions must be as detailed as possible, which is often associated with the phrase thick description. One test for descriptive validity is whether different observers or participants in the same event produce similar accounts of that event. Does everyone present or observing report the same actions and conditions? Here, we are not talking about interpretations or evaluations, but simply who said what, when, what was the arrangement or movements of the people in the spaces, the sequences of action. Let's elaborate on this by thinking about what we do when observers of a scene, an event, or an organization, for example, do produce different accounts. Researcher A produces an account of a group meeting. Researcher B visits the same group at another time and finds something different, and even perhaps contradictory. Thus, questions arise about the descriptive validity of A's account or the validity of B's account of the group meeting. How do we make sense of this difference? Did the group change its activities between the visits? Was the first observation an outlier, different than the usual activities? Did the researchers pay attention to different parts of the meeting? These questions can sometimes be resolved by examining the time and context of the observations and other knowable conditions that might have affected the setting when it was observed, or the selection of actions described if they were not all that actually took place. The differences must, however, be reconciled because the social scientist seeks to produce as complete and accurate a representation of the phenomena, in this example, the group meeting, as can possibly be accomplished. Perhaps the two different observations were not produced from observations at different times, but from different persons participating or observing at the same time. It is possible that even in the same interaction, the perspective, the position of the person may obscure what another can see. Again, the descriptions must be factual, not evaluative, and must be reconcilable.